Let's talk about Jujutsu Kaisen Chapter 234 spoilers. The full translations for this chapter will likely be out in about a day or so, so I'm gonna go over a few of the things I really wanted to talk about in this spoiler review instead. With the fact that Gojo did indeed smoke a Shikigami. The moment we heard Gojo say, "I'm going to use my unlimited holo technique," you know that at least one Shikigami was going to get dusted. So the biggest takeaway this chapter is that Mahoraga's adaptation probably goes a lot farther than anybody expected. Chimera Beast Ajito is about to wake up in heaven, and Gojo is planning for his students to help him if things get too rough. And I want to talk about Mahoraga first, because we saw what looked like Mahoraga using Dismantle to chop Gojo's arm off, which in JJK, losing your arm is just a rite of passage. And this came after Sukuna was saying, "Mahoraga, you are my shadow, not Megumi Fushiguro's." So what happened here? Well, there are a few options, because one of them is that Mahoraga can eventually use the techniques that it has fully adapted to, or Sukuna was able to impart his technique to his Shikigami in a similar way that he can use Max Elephant's water ability. And the more we learn about the wheel, the more overpowered it gets, and the more overpowered 10 Shadows gets, especially with the Chimera Beast Ajito able to tank black flashes and instantly recover from them from Gojo Satoru. And it sounds like we know what the 10th Shikigami's name is now, with the Mourned Tiger, and its ability seems to be recovering whatever it's attached to. Granted, I don't know if this is the actual translation for it, I've been lied to before with the Madoka Deer, but it sounds like there's a reveal coming here for another Shikigami, and it doesn't seem like it's a huge reveal because Gojo pretty casually mentioned this. And if Megumi gets free and he gets access to a totality of Mahoraga when Mahoraga probably gets smoked, he is going to be overpowered, and from the looks of it, a lot of the characters in the room, they think they're able to tussle with Sukuna eventually. And the main caveat here is Sukuna has to be domain free, which I mean obviously. But a huge thing a lot of people thought after Ryu died is that Sukuna is going to be too fast, but I've always kind of figured everyone's going to scale up to him eventually. Because at the end of the day, power scaling really isn't the end all be all. Gege will do what they will do, and characters get nerfed and get stronger as is necessary. So just because one feat has Sukuna blitzing Ryu, yeah, if we power scale that, Yuta should be one shot, but again, Yuta's more important than Ryu is, so he's gonna live longer, and that's just how stories work usually. And also, props to Yuta for being a man of his word after he was sweating the entire fight. And we're getting more Jump Kaisen set up here, especially with Kashimo and Yuta coming in. And Gojo had the plan for these guys to come in the whole time, and when he said, "I'll win," he meant it, because he was gonna make like 15 backups apparently. And Sukuna, he deserves to get jumped, and deserves to get humiliated in some way, because this guy really is just a sneaky rat man. And even though something is probably going to go horribly wrong, because Sukuna does have a trump card, and whether or not that's Yorzu's gift or something else, we'll have to wait and see. But we have a whole arc after this, and Sukuna dying here, it just doesn't seem that likely, or at least not permanently, because I do think Gojo is going to save Megumi. And the thing about 10 Shadows in mythology, or the 10 treasures, is that when all of these treasures are together, they are supposed to be able to heal any illness and bring back the dead. So I think this is where a lot of people get the idea that Sukuna is going to bring back the body that he ate, or bring himself back to life if Megumi is about to get free. But the bigger thing to me is that we keep getting hints that there is more to the 10 Shadows, and it sounds like there is a true climax to this technique that we have yet to see. And the more we see these Shikigami, the more it looks like Chimera Shadow Garden has the potential to be one of the most powerful domains in the entire series. If Megumi had the talent of Sukuna and his cursed energy total, his domain, you would just get drowned in Shikigami. Having all of your Shikigami have sure hits and be able to clone them while simultaneously drowning your opponent in your own element, that is just busted. And the more impressive thing about Chimera Shadow Garden is, unlike Malevolent Shrine and Limited Void, they don't need the sure hit to be useful. You pretty much spawn shadows all around you. If Megumi gets free, and I really think he will, and he has this tamed Mahoraga, or worse, a totality of it, I think out of all of Gojo's students, Megumi really does have the potential to surpass Gojo, because 10 Shadows is that good of a technique. And at the end of this chapter, we saw Chimera Beast Ajito get completely collapsed into itself by an Azure Glow. And the leaked translations called this a purple at the end, but I think that might have been a mistake, because this just looks like Azure Glow to me. Is this Gojo's maximum? Maybe, but Azure Glow was called Max maximum output as well, which has always been contentious. And this doesn't really seem to have the same oomph of an unlimited holo technique that we were promised, so I'm guessing that's going to be used on Mahoraga. And you know, for the whole one chapter Chimera Beast Ajito got to live, I thought it was a pretty cool Shikigami. The moment you see Walmart brand Mahoraga show up in tandem with Mahoraga, you know that it was destined to die. This Shikigami existed so Gojo could do something cool without directly killing Mahoraga this chapter. This is the Shikigami equivalent of a jobber. And when Mahoraga first showed up, a lot of people were thinking this thing was going to be able to 1v1 Gojo. Which clearly it can't, but it's also a lot stronger than anybody thought it was going to be in a completely different way. I have always been on the 10 Shadows Mahoraga train. I just like this technique the most. I think Gege Akutami put the most thought into this technique and Limitless. So Mahoraga getting more gas, I am all here for it because a Mahoraga buff is just a Megami buff in waiting. And even though Mahoraga is probably going to get evaporated in the next two chapters, I think that its totality will probably go into the hands of my boy Fushiguro. And if you have grandchildren and they ask you, what was the point that really pushed you over and made you doubt Sukuna's strongest claims? Well, you see, my grandson, it was when he was cradled in the arms of the giant Shikigami. And I have to say, there's something in this fight that feels a little off, in that it feels like there's about to be a plot twist, and I think that's a sense a lot of people are getting. Kenjaku is completely missing in action, off killing the Culling Games players, and we have pretty much zero comment on what their binding vow was, or what even the true purpose of the Culling Games is, because as far back as Reggie's fight with Megumi, there were hints to something deeper with the Culling Games and Tengen lying to the protagonist. And the merger creature requires everybody to be dead, which I just don't see happening, and we know that there is more Tengen was hiding about the Culling Games from Kenjaku's own mouth. And like Reggie said, there is likely to be a bombshell dropped when only the strong are left. And I think we are rapidly approaching that moment because Kenjaku knows that Sukuna is vulnerable after his fight with Gojo. And the whole setup of the characters coming out to jump Sukuna, it seems a little too in our face. We know Kenjaku does not want them to leave the battlefield. Kenjaku is just not the type of brain to leave things up to chance, and he had an entire month to plot this out alongside Sukuna. And on the note of it being Gojover, okay guys, it's never Gojover. Every time someone says it's Gojover, it's never actually Gojover. He is from a long line of thems, and Six Eyes users, they never go quietly, and that's just how it is. Even if he loses, he's going to plot a W, and will he die? A lot of people are leaning on that, and I have been leaning on that for a while, but the more I think about it, Gojo could probably live just because he makes so much goddamn money for Shonen Jump. Sometimes we gotta go fourth wall, because you know if Gege Akutami is planning to kill Gojo, there is an editor on his knees begging him to keep this guy alive. And we have no break next week, and the fight is entering its climax according to narrator comments, so I'm guessing that we probably have 2 to 3 more chapters of this fight at most. That could be wrong, it could be like 5 chapters, but Gege has been pumping out chapters non-stop for like 4 weeks in a row now. And next chapter is pretty much guaranteed to have somebody on their knees for real this time. But that's just my opinion, and I want to hear yours. What do you think the climax of Gojo versus Sukuna will be? Let me know in the comments below, and I am going to have a full chapter review once the actual translations are out in the next day or two. But if you like content like this, subscribe for more. And as always, thanks for watching.